This tutorial shows you how to conduct a point-biserial correlation in R. This correlation is used when you have a dichotomous and a continuously measured variable. Before you start, however, make sure that the dichotomous variable is not a factor, but rather numeric. In my example, male participants are coded as 0 and female participants as 1. This will be important when it comes to interpretation. For my example, I want to correlate gender and weight. Calculation. Since the point-biserial correlation is mathematically equivalent to the Pearson correlation, we can use the cor.test function. Simply enter your variables. No particular order is required. Upon running this line, you will get your results. Interpretation. You can see that the correlation is -0.53, with a p-value of 5.6 times 10 to the negative 5, which is well below any alpha threshold. The null hypothesis can therefore be rejected, which, like with every correlation, is no association. Therefore, we can observe an association between gender and weight. But what kind of association does -0.53 represent? Keep in mind that male participants are coded with 0 and female with 1. The point-biserial correlation tells us that if we increase the gender by 1, aka we go from male 0 to female 1, the weight decreases. Put another way, male participants are heavier than female participants. In other words, men are associated with higher weight than women. Of course, you can also do an independent t-test if you want to test gender for weight differences. Effect size. The effect size of the point-biserial correlation is the correlation coefficient itself, the absolute value to be precise. This means R can be classified with comparable studies or research field-specific thresholds. If neither exist, you can fall back to Cohen 92, a power primer, and use the thresholds on page 157, 0.1, 0.3, and 0.5 for small, medium, and large effect sizes. For my example, -0.53, or rather 0.53, represents a large effect according to Cohen.